Hi everyone, welcome to this channel. In the previous session, we discussed about the Unit 1 of Internet of Things. That means introduction to the unit Internet of Things, and then different concepts related to the Internet of Things. Now, you are going to know about the devices and endpoints of Internet of Things. Here, what is a IoT device? And then, what are the different examples for the IoT device? And then you have to know about the what is the IoT device, what are the different interfaces for the IoT device, how can you connect the outside environment for the IoT device. And then in this case, you are going to know about the Raspberry Pi interface. One of the example for the IoT device is a Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi is a mini computer. And then not only that one, you will discuss the Arduino interfaces, and then some of the other IoT devices. And then finally, you are going to write a program on Raspberry Pi with Python. That means you are going first, you will learn the some of the concept related to the Python, and then move on to the how can you do the program on Raspberry Pi. And then finally, domain specific IoTs. Okay, thank you. Okay. Good morning. Today's topic is IoT devices and input devices. Here, IoT devices consist of different IoT devices are there. Raspberry Pi, one IoT device, Arduino interface, another IoT device. Like that, different devices are there. Here, you are going to know about the what is a IoT device, and then some example, as well as the Raspberry Pi, and then what are the components of Raspberry Pi. Like that, you will know about the different things. Here, the IoT devices. I think you have a great idea about the IoT device. IoT device in the sense, or it is a anything, any item, a fan, light, a tube light, or anything here that is having unique identity that performing remote sensing and activation monitoring capabilities. Then only such kind of devices are called as a IoT devices. Some of the example for the IoT devices here is a smartphone, smart TV, so a computer, a refrigerator, car. These are all IoT devices. Here, let us assume a simple information about the IoT devices. Here, the IoT device in the sense that's having a special thing. It's not a physical device. Physical device in the sense, ordinary fan is a physical device. If the fan having the IP address, is having sensing capability, it's work with the internet, then that is called here IoT device. Here, these all IoT devices having a special capabilities. That's called here those type of objects. What are the special capability? Activating capability, digital capability, networked capability. These are all called as a smart IoT. The smartness in IoT, these objects are called as a smart object. If it comes to the light, if it comes to the fan, if it comes to the mobile, if it comes to the car, these are all connected each other. Here, send data from one device to another device. That's called here, this type of devices are called as a smart devices. These are all called as IoT devices. Here, some of the things, for example, smart home system, smart cities are the different IoT devices here. And then IoT devices exchange data from one data to another device. Here, IoT device includes a computer devices, software, as well as the sensor and actuators. Here, IoT devices are connected over the internet. That is a main important point. Here, for example, you have some example of the IoT devices. Home automation device, one kind of device here is a home automation. For home automation, you are connecting different things to the mobile phone or laptop. Here allows remotely monitoring the status of a appliances. All appliances in our home, you have a different appliances are there, either a cube light, either a surveillance camera. Here anything here, it will identify the status of all appliances. For example, that's a home automation device. The diagram indicates the home automation device diagram. And then industrial machine is one of the example here. Here it would send information about the operation and health monitoring data to the server. Here, what is the industrial machine here? It's that means it sends information about the operation and health monitoring data. Here, different parts of a that means it will send some server. That is a industrial automation system. Here, coming to the car. Your car is a one type of example for the IoT device here. Your car sends a information about the location to the cloud. That means the bottom of the top of the diagram indicates the cloud based information, and bottom car it sends a some information to the cloud based computing services. That is a thing. And then wireless enabled wearable devices here. Another one, wireless. That means what is a wireless enabled devices here? These devices that means measures data about the person here, such as the number of steps walked and send a data to the cloud based services here. This is a different examples here. You have a building blocks of IoT. Since I think you have idea previously, sensing capability, activation capability, communication capability, analysis and processing capability. These are all building blocks of IoT system. Always each and every IoT device and these information here. The IoT device consists of, that means device in the sense it's having some kind of component for interfacing with the other devices. Why? Because the IoT devices sends a data to one device to other device. Here you have some connectivity interfaces are there, processors are there. That means some of the components existed in a IoT device. And then graphics, and then audio video interfaces are there, memory interfaces, storage interfaces, some of the interfaces here, special kind of interfaces, SPI, I2C, CAN, UART, like that you have a different interfaces. That means the diagram, the block diagram consists of different component. This component interfacing to the other things here. For example, USB host, Ethernet for providing the connectivity to the internet. Like that, you have a different interface devices are there. Here, for example, these are all IO interfaces for the sensor, interfaces for the internet connectivity, memory and storage interfaces, audio and video interfaces are there. These are all different block diagram interfaces. You have a, I think you have some certain properties are there. Here the IoT devices having the sensing probability, send and receiving data probability. That means these properties, sensing data, that means sending data to, that means it will sense the data, sensing in the sense retrieving the physical parameter from the environment, retrieving the physical parameter from the environment, that's called, and send receive data. Here it will send the data to other devices, or it will send the data to servers. It will send, that means this type of information done by using IoT devices. Here anything done by you with the help of over the internet connection. Analyzing capability, analyzing here it will analyze the data coming from the server or send it to the server. Here controlling capability, here endpoint, that means IoT device may control from some endpoint here. Here IoT devices are themselves communicate with each other. Here at least two, that means without failure of system. These are all property. Very important thing here is a IoT devices, different types of IoT devices. You are having different types of IoT devices. One is a accessories devices. Here sensors, activators, switches, display. You will discuss in next concept about the accessory devices. Here next ordinary, that means embedded system based devices. Some of the devices are embedded system, Arduino, one type of system based device, Raspberry Pi. The next class, the next thing, that means you are going to know about the Raspberry Pi. Here, that means some of the cubic boards. So that means you are not discussing this cubic board, Intel Galileo. That means in the first unit, you discussed about the Intel Galileo, how it will works. And then you will discuss here clearly about the Raspberry Pi and then Arduino kit. These two devices, coming to the wearable devices, already you have Google glasses, one type of wearable devices, watches here, one type of devices, like that you have a different devices are there. The next coming class, that means you will discuss about the Raspberry Pi. The important concept here, the Raspberry Pi and Arduino. Here the devices, here IoT device in the sense the representation of IoT device is a single board mini computer. Here is called here Raspberry Pi. It is a, the representation here. How can you represent the Raspberry Pi not IoT device? The representation of IoT device is called Raspberry Pi. Or the Raspberry Pi or IoT device, both are similar. One type of IoT device, Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi IoT, why it is as Raspberry Pi IoT device? It's having the sensing capability. It's having the analysis capability. It's having the different sending and receiving capability. Then only this this is called here Raspberry Pi is a IoT device. Here, what is a Raspberry Pi? The Raspberry Pi is a low cost mini computer with the physical size of credit card size. With the credit card or debit card size, it will come here. That is a Raspberry Pi. Here you will know about the Raspberry Pi, and then that means next coming section you will know about the Raspberry Pi programming with Python, and then that after that you will know about the Arduino interfaces and then some of the other IoT devices. Here this is a some description about the IoT devices. Here coming to the best example for the IoT device, here is a Raspberry Pi. What is a Raspberry Pi here? Here what is a Raspberry Pi? Raspberry Pi is a low cost mini computer with physical size of credit card size. The size of the Raspberry Pi here, the right side diagram indicates the size of the Raspberry Pi is a credit card size. Here the Raspberry Pi consists of different components. Here what are the different components? Audio jack, as it previously the device in the sense audio jack, in order to that means audio, and then RCA video, and then GPIO header, GPIO pins. These are all called, the right diagram indicates the GPIO pins, and then SD card. Under the Raspberry Pi you have a SD card. You will inserting the SD card. Why? Because the Raspberry Pi not having any storage. Here not having any operating system. You will install the operating system in a SD card. That means you will store the operating system in a SD card, and then you will install. It's not having any operating system itself, having not having any operating system and storage. But here you may insert the SD card. For inserting the SD card, you have a SD card slot under the Raspberry Pi. Here that and other one here is a micro USB power, HDMI, HDMI for a video, audio interface. This one, and then Ethernet. Here in order to providing the internet, here you will use a Ethernet interface. Here in the component, these components all are called as a, these all components are called as a, what is the, these components? Interfaces. Already you discussed in a previous session about the IoT interfaces. Here another important one here is a Raspberry Pi runs on a different flavors of Linux. Here all flavors of Linux, here Ubuntu Linux, and then Raspbian, and then Nudes, like that different flavors of Linux. That means the Raspberry Pi perform almost all tasks that normal desktop computer can do. Here whatever may be the task done by the normal computer, that means those all tasks done by the Raspberry Pi. What are the tasks done by the normal computer? Here the normal computer, from the normal computer, by using normal computer you will browse the internet, and then you will perform some of the word processing. Here word processing in the sense you will type the some books or something else, word processing. And then other important thing here, by using computer you can perform, you can play the games. Here by using this Raspberry Pi also you can perform in the different games. Here whatever may be the work, whatever may be the task done by the ordinary computer, those tasks done by the our Raspberry Pi. Here that's why Raspberry Pi is a fully functional computer. Here which is called as a fully functional computer. Why? Because fully functional computer, it's having the browsing capability, Raspberry Pi, and then it's having the word processing capability, it's having the playing games capability. And then by using Raspberry Pi you will develop the IoT based application. Here different any IoT based, the home automation system, smart cities, smart environment, like that you will perform the any all developing the IoT based applications, different IoT based application only by using this Raspberry Pi. I think you have clear idea about that one. Here Raspberry Pi allows interfacing sensors and actuators here. Here which will allows the different interfacing sensor here by using general purpose GPIO pins. Here you have a the diagram here shows the pins, some of the pins are there, GPIO pins. Here by you, with the help of that means I can show you the GPIO pins. Here these are all GPIO pins. Here these are all our GPIO pins. Here with the help of GPIO pins you will perform the interfacing here, that is called here, that is a Raspberry Pi. Here Raspberry Pi runs on a operating system, it supports the Python out of the box. Here always the Raspberry Pi, Pi in the sense Raspberry, Raspberry in the sense Raspberry, and then Pi in the sense Python programming. Here always Raspberry Pi supports the Python programming here, and then it considers the superior at a software application. Always the Raspberry Pi consider a superior different application. Here if you see here general purpose input output pins, here these are all, that means this is a latest version. I am showing the versions, different version. For example, it is a old version, different versions are there, 1.2 Raspberry Pi 2, Raspberry Pi 3, it's a 2, I think this is a 500 MB RAM, this consists of, it's a 2. The next version, this is a 3, Raspberry Pi 3, this one, different versions. Here nowadays you are using the Raspberry Pi 4. Here the Raspberry Pi 4 having the different things here, IoT port, IoT port, that means Ethernet port for internet connectivity, USB cable like this, and then AV jack. Here Raspberry Pi 4 HDMI port, video audio, and then camera module is there, USB power port is there here, and then here comes to here an external display port, micro SD card slot, different slots are there here. This is called Raspberry Pi 4, Raspberry Pi 4, that means different versions came here. This is a, it is considered superior at a software application. It was developed to encourage the basic learning for the computer science student. Here for the students, children's the basic learning for the computer science and other growing countries. That means it consists of 64 squared processor and microprocessor. It's having the 64 bit quad core processor. Here other important thing here is a Raspberry Pi 1 GB of RAM. Here if you comes to the 1 GB of RAM, there's a new version. Here old version consists of 500 GB of RAM, like that. Here 256 of RAM, like that. But I am telling you about the new version, Raspberry Pi 4. Raspberry Pi 4 having the 1 GB of RAM, and then the foundation of Raspberry Pi provides the operating system such as Linux. Here always it's having the Linux operating system. It provides a non-Linux operating system also. It also provides a non-Linux operating system, OpenBSD. I don't know about this operating system, and then NetBSD, Helen OS, like that. It supports the non-Linux operating systems also. Here the types of Raspberry Pi are Raspberry Pi Alternative, Raspberry Pi 0W, Raspberry Pi 3 Model B Plus. You can run all type of application in a Raspberry Pi. Here what, which type of application you may run here, Microsoft Office also you can run in a Raspberry Pi. Emails, you will transfer in the mails from one person to another person, and then specific code for an electronic projects. That means you can performing all these different tasks by using Raspberry Pi. And then one important thing here is you can run a single or different pieces of code in a Raspberry Pi. Here you can run the different code in a ordinary computer, that can be done in by using Raspberry Pi, since Raspberry Pi is a mini computer. Here, other important things here is the operating system, all the files. So that means the Raspberry Pi does not having the any storage. It's not having any operating system. But here, the operating system in all files is saved in a SD card. Here, that means you take the operating system in a SD card and then put in a slot. They are providing a one slot for SD card. Place that one in a SD card. Here for one Raspberry Pi, you can have the multiple SD cards for different operating system and file system. Here you may use the multiple SD cards for the one operating system. It is a consistent in many programming languages. Here it is easily connected to the internet. Why? Because how can you connect the internet here? By using, there is a one slot is there, Ethernet slot. By using this Ethernet slot here, you will easily connect it to the internet. That is a thing. Another important one here is the design of Raspberry port consists of different parts. CPU is there. Ordinary computer has the CPU like that. It has the CPU, GPU, graphical processing unit, graphics, audio, video, files for performing that one. You will use a graphics thing, and then RAM. And then Zigbee port also there, Ethernet port also there, and then different ports, and then UART, asynchronous receiver and transmitter port is there, and then GPIO, general purpose input output pins are there, different general purpose and output pins. Here, some other important thing about the Raspberry Pi here comes to the 4 point, I think, 4. Raspberry Pi ranges from the 7 megahertz to 1.5 gigahertz. Hard drive here, that means there is a slot, the slot on the board, which is called here. That means there is a hard drive for the Raspberry Pi, is the slot on the board in which the SD card is inserted. That means you can insert the SD card on a hard drive. The Raspberry Pi having the capability here converting the analog to digital. For that purpose, we are using the analog to digital converter is attached to the Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi having a 40 input output pins on the board. Here we have a 40 pins are there. Here it consists of input and output pins. Here GPIO pins are different from input and output pins. That is some information about the Raspberry Pi. Here, this is the components of a Raspberry. In the next section, we will discuss about the components of a Raspberry Pi. Here, these are all different components of a Raspberry Pi. One is a HDMI, and then CSI computer camera, Ethernet, USB, status LED, audio jack, RCA video, GPIO header. Now, like that, SD card slot, USB power, like that, you have a different slots are there. The first thing here is a processor and ROM. The Raspberry Pi components consist of processor and ROM. I am telling you this one as per our book, this is a old version. That means it's based on a RAM processor. RAM, this particular Raspberry Pi based on a RES processor. The latest version model B revision 2, that means at the time of getting the book, it is a latest version 3. This comes with the 700 megahertz low power and 512 MB RAM. That is a old version, this one. Nowadays you are using the 1 GB RAM also, and then USB ports are there. Here USB ports, see here, different USB ports are there. What is the purpose of USB port here? The two USB 2.0 ports are there. It provides a current up to 100 amps, and then for connecting the devices that draw the current more than amps, external USB power is required for this one. That means some information about this one. Other kind of information here is Ethernet ports here. Here, if you come to the right side of the diagram, the Ethernet port is there. Here, what is the main purpose of this Ethernet port here? This Ethernet port used to providing the internet connectivity. Here you can connect, that means you can connect an Ethernet cable or USB Wi-Fi adapter to provide the internet connectivity. Here you will connect the wireless cable or Ethernet cable or USB Wi-Fi adapter also. Here you may connect with the help of this Ethernet. Here you will provide the this internet connectivity. Other one here is a HDMI output here. What is an HDMI output here in this case? Here under the diagram, under the there is a HDMI port is there. What is an HDMI port here? The HDMI port provides a both video and audio output. Video, that means by using this port here, you will display the data. That means you may connect to the simply monitor, or you may connect to the simply your TV. So that means from the TV here itself, you may convert it into computer. Why? Because TV is a one type of monitor. Here you may connect the TV. That means old type of TVs. In order to connecting the old type of TV, you are using the HDMI. Here you can connect the Raspberry Pi to monitor using HDMI cable. Okay, HDMI output. Here comes to the this HDMI output here. You can connect the Raspberry Pi to monitor using HDMI cable here. Just like you are connecting the TV, just like that, you are connecting the monitor. Here for monitor that have the DVI port, but no HDMI port nowadays. Here you can use the HDMI to DVI port adapter or cable. It required another cable here. That is a something about the HDMI to connect with the monitor. To that means it provides a video and audio output by using this HDMI port. Very important concept. How can you connect the HDMI port? If you take the one Raspberry Pi, if you have some knowledge, you will buy one Raspberry Pi and then apply some of the tasks on this Raspberry Pi. Next one here is a composite video audio output. Here the composite video audio output here is a RCA video and then audio jack. These are all called as a composite video audio output. RCA video and then audio jack. Here what is this one here? The Raspberry Pi comes with composite video output with RCA jack. Here what is the RCA jack here? RCA jack supports the video output. RCA jack can be used to connect the old type of TV, not a new type of TV that have the RCA input only. Here it will, this particular RCA jack connect to the old type of TVs. Here coming to the audio output. Here what is an audio output here? Audio output here is a Raspberry Pi has the 3.5 mm audio input jack. This is used for, what is the main purpose of this output port, this audio output here? That means providing the audio output to old TVs for providing the along with the RCA jack for video. Here providing the audio for this purpose, you are using the this combination RCA video and audio jack. Here that is a simple information. Coming to the seventh, next one here is a GPIO. It's very important one here. GPIO, where you are identifying the GPIO pins here, you will identify the GPIO pins in the top of the Raspberry Pi consists of GPIO pins. Here, what are the GPIO pins here? The Raspberry Pi comes with the number of GPIO pins. That means you are categories or totally different pins are there. GPIO pins, GPIO, GPIO 14 pin, GPIO 15, GPIO 18, and then GPIO 22, 23. GP like that, you have a different GPIO pins are there. Here I2C interface pins. Here divided into four different categories. Here divided into four different categories. One is a I2C interface pins. Other one is a SPI interface pins. Other one is a serial receiver pins and then transmitter transmit pins. These four are different categories of pins. Here GPIO comes with the different pins. Here this is called here GPIO pins structure. This is a GPIO pin structure of a Raspberry Pi. Here that means it consists of some voltage here. The voltage in the sense 2 5 volts pins, and then 2 3 V3 pins are present on the board. You may use, that means it's, I think it's a new version of pins that consists of some of the voltage pins. Other one here is a output pins. Here what are the output in GPIO pins? GPIO pins designed as an output pin can set high in the sense the 3 V3 high, 0 volt in the sense low, and other kind of pins, input pins. What about the input pins here? The it is used to read a high or low value. This is made easy with the use of internal pull up and pull down resistors. That is a simple information. Some output pins, input pins. Here other one here is a serial pins. Here what is a serial here? The serial interface pins are transmit or receiver pins. What is the necessity of this transmit and receiver pins? Here we have a TX and T pins are there. Transmit and receiver pins. Here what is the necessity of these pins here? For establishing the communication. For communication with the serial peripherals. Here for providing the communication with the serial peripheral, you will use a receiver and transmit pins. That is a simple information. Other important one here is a SPI pins. Important pins, serial peripheral interface is an asynchronous serial data protocol used for communicating for the one or more peripheral devices. Here for performing communication with the one or more IoT devices, you are using the SPI pins. You have a five different SPI pins on a Raspberry Pi. Here what are those MISO, master in master slave out, and then MOSA, master out and slave in, and then serial clock, and then SIP enable 0, SIP enable 1. Here these are all called as a SPI interface pins. 5 master MISO, master line for the sending data to the peripheral, and one MOSA, slave line for sending the data to the master. That is, these are all different pins. Pin structure in a GPIO, and then serial clock. For what about the serial clock here? The clock generated by the master to synchronize the data transmission. Here enable or disable device. This one also enable or disable device. This is a something about the different interfaces. Other one is a Raspberry Pi interface. In the Raspberry Pi interface, GPIO. In the GPIO, I2C interface pin on the Raspberry Pi allows you to connect a hardware module. Here, if you want to connect the hardware module here, you use a I2C. Here, this particular I2C allows a synchronous data transfer with two pins. Here, what are the synchronous data? You are sending some data. It will reach. Definitely, it will reach. That is called a synchronous. Asynchronous data in the sense, here mobile phone, tower to mobile phone. That is called here asynchronous transfer. And then SDA data line, SCL clock line. By using these clock line and SDA and SCL, you will allow the synchronous data transfer. That is a simple information about the GPIO pins. Other type of information is there. Display serial interface. What about the serial interface? One of the component of the Raspberry Pi. Here displaying the serial interface. Here use it to connect an LCD panel to the Raspberry Pi. LCD, that means what about display serial interface? By using this display serial interface, you will connect it to the LCD panel to Raspberry Pi, and then camera serial interface is there. Here, what about the camera serial interface? Use it to connect a camera module to the Raspberry Pi, and then other one here, status LED. Here, the status LED having the different 5 status LEDs. The LED in the sense light. ACT, PWR, FDX, LNX, 100. These five are called as a status LEDs, showing the status SD card access, whether SD card placing or not. And then PWR, 3.3 volts power is preset. And then FDX, full duplex LAN connected. And then LNX, link or network activity. Like that, you have a different modules are then different components are there. Here, in addition to this component, you have a one SD card slot. Here, Raspberry Pi do not having the built-in operating system and storage. That's why there is a requirement of a SD card slot. Okay, thank you.
Okay, in the previous session, we discussed about the IoT devices and then some of the example for the IoT devices. And then we discussed some of the concept regarding the Raspberry Pi and different interfaces for the Raspberry Pi. Now we are going to know about the Arduino interfaces. Here, what is the Arduino board? What are the components of Arduino board? And then what are the functions of these components? I'm going to explain this information. If it comes to the Arduino board, see here, Arduino board appears like this. Here, what is the Arduino board? I'm removing this one. Here, what is the Arduino board here? The Arduino board, this one is a Arduino board. Here, the Arduino board is a open source software and hardware platform. And then it is a, some having the own IDE. Here, if it comes to the interfaces for the Arduino board, here the, this interface you call it as a, this one. Here, power USB, and then other one is a, this one is a, some power barrel jack. And then if you comes to here, this is a voltage, the voltage regulator. And then if you comes to here, this one is a crystal oscillator. And then you have a different pin, reset pins are there. Here, if you come to here, here one is a reset pin, and then there is a reset button is there. This one is a reset button. This one is a reset button. And then if it comes to here to here, some of the 5 to 9, some voltage and then ground pins. Here you will find out the voltage and ground pins here. And then comes to the some of the analog pins are there. These pins are called as a analog pins. And then coming to the, these are all analog pins. This one is a microcontroller. This board indicates the microcontroller. I can explain you the functionality of each and every later. This is a microcontroller. And then ICSP pins are there. These are all call it as a ICSP pins. And then there is a LED indicator is there. And then there, this one is a, you'll identify the TX and RX. Here, this is a TX as well as the RX LEDs. And then there is a digital IO pins. These are all called as a digital IO pins. 14 digital IO pins you will identify here. And then analog reference, one analog reference pins are there. Totally 17 different interfaces available in a Arduino board. This Arduino board is a freely available open source hardware and software environment. And then it's having the own IDE. Here, this is implemented by using a C++. That means you will write your program by using C++ code. That is a something about the Arduino. If it comes to the, yeah, this is a Arduino board. Some information related to the Arduino board. And then coming to the Arduino, what is the Arduino board? And then what are the information regarding the Arduino board kit? Here, what is an Arduino board? It is an open source hardware software platform. Arduino is defined as a, it is a microcontroller board. This is called here simply microcontroller board. This is help to make the project simpler. For example, some of the, so it is easy to store. That means just like it's a, works just like a computer. And then this was developed to create a microcontroller kit, which was used to build electronic devices. What is the main purpose of this Arduino kit here is a for creating the more number of electronic devices here. By using these devices, you will creating the more number of IoT devices. So many IoT devices we will build by using build and design by using this type of Arduino kit. Here, the most Arduino kits are comes with the 8-bit microcontroller. The microcontroller here is an 8-bit here, and then it's having the flash memory as well as the static random access memory. Here, what about the flash memory and static random memory here? And then 32K bytes flash memory is there, and then 2K bytes SRAM available in this Arduino kit. And then flash memory consists of stored state of Arduino, while SRAM manipulate the processing of variables. Here, that means you are defining different variable. In order to processing those variables, you are using this information. This is some information regarding the Arduino kit. And then the Arduino promotes a C++ as a primary programming language. Here you are using the C++ primary programming language. Here it's not having any operating system, no operating system here. Here that means the software requires either Windows or Linux, Mac OS operating system to run the programs here. Here, if you comes to the Raspberry Pi, the Raspberry Pi consists of there is a separate slot for the operating system. That means in that slot you insert a SD card, and then you will do some. That means you may work on Linux operating system, Raspberry Pi. If you comes to the you require Windows or Linux, Mac OS operating system to run a programs. That means most probably that means you are using C++ programming language for writing. That means there is a separate IDE is there for this Arduino interface. And then the type of Arduino, you have a different types of Arduino available. You have a n number of, for example, Arduino Uno. That means you are using the Arduino Uno, and then Arduino Nano, like the different boards also available. And then started kit for the beginners, Arduino Shield for the printed circuit expansion board here, and then standard Arduino boards, and then boards with advanced features also available. Here Arduino runs a single piece of code over and over again, and then due to this, that means you will run only single piece of code. It starts quickly as soon as you on power. That means it is easy to on. And then coming to the, it's having the, already I explained you, the Arduino kit having the own integrated development environment here, which is limited to the programming interfaces. And then that means in order to running the C++ programming, you having the own IDE. And design of Arduino board consists of different controllers and microprocessors. And then some boards also includes a USB models, and then serial communication interfaces. Already explained. That means I shown you the latest one, that is latest version of Arduino board. That means some of the board consists of USB cable. That means you, in order to attaching or in order to providing interface for the, you will use a USB cable, and then some of the models, and then serial communication interfaces. Here the processor speed, here how can you represent the processor speed here for this one? In the latest one, I am considering the latest one, 8 megahertz to 400 megahertz. The average speed in this case here is Arduino 16 megahertz. And then coming to the project of Arduino is connected to the computer. That means computer using USB port. And then in this case, you have some of the converters also available here. Which type of converters are available here? Analog to a digital converter inbuilt in a Arduino board. Here Arduino, you know, having a 16 digital IO pins are there. 16 digital IO pins, already I shown you. These are all 16 digital IO pins and 6 analog pins and power pins available. Here coming to the Arduino interfaces, the interfaces in the sense, some of the components, that means those interfaces attached to the outside the environment, some of the components available in a Arduino interface, Arduino board. In the Arduino board, we have a different interfaces also available. That means some of the components are available. Already explained the different component. We are coming to the first component here. Here, see here, number one. The number one here is the power USB. Here, what is the power USB? Here, Arduino board can be powered by using USB cable from the your computer. And then all you need to do connect the USB cable to the USB connection. That means in order to connecting USB cable, you use a power USB. And then there is a barrel jack. Here Arduino boards can be powered directly from, that means from AC power supply connecting to the barrel jack. That means directly you will connect to the barrel jack. Here coming to the voltage regulator. Here what is the third one? Here if you comes to the board, here third one indicates that this one is a voltage regulator. Here what is a voltage regulator in this case? The function of voltage regulator to control the voltage given to the Arduino board. That means it is used to controlling and stabilizing the DC voltages. Here for controlling stabilizing DC voltages, you will use this voltage regulator, and then used by the processor and other elements. And then fourth one is a crystal oscillator. What is a crystal oscillator? See here, the fourth one indicates the this one crystal oscillator. Here, what is the functionality of crystal oscillator? Here, the crystal oscillator Arduino dealing with the time issues. The functionality in this case, this oscillator, some of the time issues here. That means how does the Arduino calculate the time? And then how does the Arduino calculate the time? By using this oscillator. And then tells us, that means the frequency is in particular range here. Here, this is a frequency range. That is a crystal oscillator, the fourth important component here. Here, coming to the fifth one. The fifth one in this case here is one pin is there, the reset pin. The fourth one and seventh one are the reset pins here. Here, the seventh one is a reset button. Here, reset pin. Here, you can reset your Arduino board. That means restarting, reset. That means start your program from the beginning. You can reset button. You can use the reset button. Here the reset, you know about two ways. That means you will performing the reset operation in a two way. The first ways here is by using reset button. Here there is in 17, number 17 in the top here, you will identify the button. A simple button, you will call it as a reset button. Here what are the reset button? Here you can reset the your, that means reset in the sense you will start your program from the starting. And then second, you will identify the, you can connect the external reset button to the Arduino pin. That means you will take the one button, you will connect that button to the this pin. There is a reset pin. The fifth one indicates the reset pin. That is called here Arduino reset pin. Here, that means there is a label is there here. Reset, see here, reset. The label for the particular pin, there is a label here that indicates the reset pin. That means you will connect the outside the reset button, from the outside the reset button to the pin, and then you will perform the reset operation here. And then coming to the 6 to 9, here if you comes to here, this one is a sixth one, this one is a seventh pin. And then here if you identify the some labels are there, 3 voltage and then 5 voltage and then ground pin and then some other pins here, 6 to 9. Here 6 to 9 are 4 different pins are available here. 3.3 volt pins. That means it is used to supplying the 3.3 volt. That means that's a negative volt. Just like a simple representation, negative voltage or positive voltage like that. And then 3.3 output voltage. And then coming to the 5 volts here. The seventh pin indicates the 5 volts. Here you will identify the 5 volts pin here. The 5 volts pin here. What is the necessity of 5 volts here? This 5 volts pin, the 5 volts outputs volt supply. And then most of the component used in an Arduino board works with works fine with 3.3 volts and 5.5 volts. Here coming to the 8th pin. Here in this case, 8th pin here is a ground pin. Here you have a ground pin is there. Here what is a ground pin here? There are several ground pins on the Arduino board. Here any of which can be used to ground your circuit. That means you will use any one of the pin here. Here for example, here two different pins are there. G and D here, G and D pin, and then here is a G and D pin. That is a pin, and then wind pin. This pin also used to power the Arduino board from the external power source, like a AC mains power to power supply. That means in order to providing this information, you have a different pins available. Here coming to the 10th one. Here coming, what is the 10th pin here? Here, this one, the main microcontroller pin. Here, what is the necessity of this microcontroller? The microcontroller, that means it is a heart, that means the 10th pin, 11th pin microcontroller. Okay, 10th pin, coming to the, you have a different pins are there. Analog pins, that if you identify 10 here, analog pins. Here, what are the analog pins here? Arduino Uno board having the 6 analog pins available. That means those are all the label here, A0, A1, A2, and then A5. There is a labels available here, A0 to A1. Here, what about these pins here? These pins can be read signal from the analog sensor. Analog sensor like humidity sensor, temperature sensor, and converted into digital value. Here the main intention of sensor here is a takes the physical parameter. The physical parameter here is a sensors, or that means physical parameter here is a temperature, humidity. That means that humidity converted into digital value, the digital electrical form of data. That is called here sensor. That means actuator is a different here. Actuator is a takes the electrical form converted into physical. For example, motor is a actuator. What is the work of motor here? Motor takes the electrical form of data and then convert it into water, the physical form of data. That is a actuator. That is a difference here. Here in this case here, you have a different pins are there. These pins read signal from the analog sensors. Here any analog sensors, humidity sensors, temperature sensor, and then that converted into digital value that can be read by the microcontroller. That means for the reading that information to the microcontroller, you have a this pins are available, converting from one form of data to another form of data. You will use a this 10th pins A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, and then A0. These pins read a signal from the sensor. Here that's converted into electrical form or a digital format of data. That is called here analog pin. That is a main purpose of analog pins. Here coming to the 11th one. Here if you see here, the right side here, the board consists of 11th one. Microcontroller. What is the main purpose of microcontroller here? Here each and every board consists of microcontroller. Here the microcontroller in the sense, for example, if you comes to the computer, the microcontroller is a main brain of your computer. Is it correct or not? Brain. It's just like a brain. Here each Arduino board have its own controller. And then you can assume it as a brain of your board. And then the main integrated circuit on the Arduino is different from the board to board. That means in this board, the microcontroller appears like this. Here some other case, you will place somewhere else. No, that means, for example, it is the latest version of board. Here, if it comes to the previous version, you will have the board in a certain other place. That means the integrated circuit on an Arduino is different from board to board. And then the microcontrollers are usually of Atmel company. That means Atmel Mega. Why? Because here this microcontroller board based on a Atmel Mega 328P data sheet. 328P data sheet here. Here this is a open source hardware and software platform used to design and build the electronic devices. Here for designing the electronic devices, you will use this board. This board having the brain of, that means the brain. This is a microcontroller, and then you must know what IC your board having, and then before loading up and loading up a new program from the Arduino IDE, and then this information available on a top of the IC. That is a some description about the Arduino board. And then the main important thing here, they will ask, sometimes they may ask about the 3 marks question. What is the microcontroller in a Arduino board? And then what are the work of microcontroller in a Arduino board? How can you represent the microcontroller? Where you are placing the microcontroller in a board? Here, that is a simple information. The 11th one indicates the microcontroller. You are coming to the 12th one. ICSP pin, integrated circuit, and then serial peripheral pin. It is a AVE studio like that. A programming header for the Arduino. Here it consists of a MOSI, MISO. I think you know very well about this MO. That means in the Raspberry Pi, I explained about the master out slaving, master in slave out. And then SCK, SCK0, SCK1, and then reset, VCC, ground. Here, this pin, the 12th one here in this case, here you have a 6 different pins available here. Here, what are the 6 different pins here in this case? The one is a MOSI, master out and slave in pin. Here, already explained that concept in a Raspberry Pi. And then MISO, another pin, and then SCK, reset, and then VCC, and then ground pins. Here you have a another ground pin. That means in the second place also there is a ground pin, 8th one. 8th place also there is a ground pins also available. Here also there is, that's why some number of ground pins available in a Arduino board. And then it is referred to as a SPI. SPI, that means SPI means serial peripheral interface, which can be considered as a expansion of output. That means you are getting the output here in this. You are solving the output devices to master of SPI bus. That means there is a bus, you will inserting that bus in these pins. From this, you will solve the problem. This is a something about the ICSP pins. We are coming to the power LED indicator. Here 13 one, here there is a power LED indicator. Here this one, I think this one is a 13. This one, what is this one here? This pin used to light up. That means LED should light up when you plug your Arduino into the power source to indicate that your board is power up correctly. That is the main purpose here. In order to power up the your board here, you will use a LED. That means that it's an indication. Here, if light does not turn on, then there is a something wrong in the connection. That means based on this line, if a line is on, then is a light is on, no problem here. The system working correctly. That means it's a having the, if it is not light on, that means wrong connection is there. You are connecting the wrong, that means for the interfaces, you are connecting from the external sources, some connection is wrong. You are coming to the 14th one. Here, what about the 14th one here? TX and RX. TX and RX LEDs here. This 14th one, see here. TX as well as the RX. TX as well as the RX LEDs. Here, what about this one here? On your board, you will find a two labels, TX and then RX. Here, what is the meaning of TX here? Transmit, and then RX means receive. Here, this appears two places on a Arduino Uno board. Here, first thing here is a at the digital pin 0 and 1. Here, what are the digital pin here? The digital pin in the board, if you see here, board TX value digital pin 0 and 1. 0 and 1 to indicate the pin responsible for the serial communication. Here, pin responsible for the serial communication, that indicates the this pin. And then second pin, that means somewhere else also it available, TX pins. Here somewhere also available, that means I cannot see that one. Here there is another way. Okay, in our board we have a second TX and RX LED here. Here, what about the TX and RX LED? TX LED flashes with a different speed while sending the serial data. And then speed of flashing depends upon a baud rate used by the board here. And then RX flashes, burning the receiving process here. Your main purpose of this TX and RX pins here is a receive and then transmit. Here you will identify these pins in two places, not in single place here. Here at the digital pins 0 and 1. Here you will identify the digital pins 0 and 1. There is a, I think, digital pins 0 and 1. Yes, somewhere else is there. Digital pin 0 and 1. Yeah, you will identify here. Yeah, here is the TX and RX 0 and 1. Digital pin 0 and 1. You will identify the this TX RX pins. What is the main purpose there here? To indicate the responsible for the serial communication. And then second way, that means TX and RX LEDs. They appear in the appear as a TX and RX LEDs. Here this one is a flashing, that means LED on or off. There is a information is there. That is a 14 pin. Here coming to the digital I/O pins. Here 15 one. Here yeah. In the 15 digital I/O pins. In this pins here there is a 0 and 1 indicates the TX as well as the RX pin. Here this pin, two pins, the TX as well as the RX pins here. And then coming to the digital I/O pins. The digital I/O pins, 14 digital I/O pins available here. And then 6 for the pulse width modulation output. And then some other pins can be configured to work with the work as a input digital pins to read a logic values 0 or 1. That is a these different pins here. And then this pins label can be used to generate a pulse width modulation. Here this if you see here, the board consists of at the top consists of 14 pins available, 14 different pins. Among the 14 pins, you have a TX and RX pins also available. And then coming to the next important last and final one in this case here is a AREF. AREF means analog reference. Here the 16th pin, the top here, you will identify the analog reference pin. Here what is used to set a external reference voltage. Here that voltage may be 0 to 5 volts. Here that means as a upper limit for the analog pin. That is a simple information regarding the Arduino interfaces. Here Arduino interfaces. Here that means you will download the Arduino interfaces freely available. Here if you like, next I can show you the link for the Arduino interfaces. From the Arduino interfaces you will download that one. Here if you download that one, you will install that one in your system. There is a IDE available. In that IDE you will write your programming. That is a simple information about the Arduino. Okay, thank you. Yeah, in this session we are going to know about the other devices. Here what are the other devices? PC Duino, PC plus Arduino, PC Duino, and then Beagle Bone Block, and then QB Board. These are all different other IoT devices. Here you are comparing these other IoT devices with the Raspberry Pi. here what is a Raspberry Pi, what are the elements in a Raspberry Pi, and then how can you comparing this Raspberry Pi with the PC Duino and then BeagleBone and then Cubic Board. That means there is a comparison is there. First you have to know about the Raspberry Pi. It's a mini computer, everyone knows. Operating system, it's need some operating system to work. It requires some SD card to store the operating system. That is a Raspberry Pi. Here some of the information regarding the Raspberry Pi, the specifications are there. Here you have to comparing the Raspberry Pi specification with the other device specification. Here what is the CPU, what is the GPU? GPU, the Raspberry Pi CPU 700 megahertz low power ARM application processor, and then GPU dual core video core, and then multimedia co-processor, and then you have a memory. The memory size here is a 512 MB SRAM, static RAM. That means nowadays you will use a 1 GB RAM, and then Ethernet on board 10/100 Ethernet RJ45 jack is there. USB dual USB connector available in a Raspberry Pi. And then for video output you are using the HDMI. For audio output you are using the 3.5 mm jack or HDMI also one type of audio output device. That means we are producing the audio. That means output by using HDMI or 3.5 mm jack. Onboard storage. Here what is the onboard storage here? HDMI, MMC, SDIO card slot. And then operating system you are using in a Raspberry Pi, Linux operating system. Your programming here is a Python programming. Here that is a simple information regarding the Raspberry Pi. And then coming to the other devices. Here we are comparing other devices with the Raspberry Pi. Here PC Duino. PC Duino in the sense PC plus Arduino. Here PC plus Arduino you call it as a PC Duino. Here what is a PC Duino here? This board is a similar to the Raspberry Pi. It is becoming like the new size for the developer here. Here the PC Duino is a more powerful than the Raspberry Pi. Here it has all features of Raspberry Pi, but it is more powerful one. Here what is the thing here compared to the Raspberry Pi, PC Duino is having the more powerful capabilities, and then that's why it is a more expensive. You need to invest a money for the Raspberry Pi. You need to invest for example 2000. For this one you need to invest the more money compared to the Raspberry Pi. Here it's having the 2 GB flash memory, and then there is a SD card up to 32 GB. Here that's having the capability. Here comes to the here. This is a PC Duino board structure. Here the PC Duino board structure consists of whatever may be the interfaces existed for the Raspberry Pi. All interfaces available here. Here processor is there. Some of the other things here. HDMI is there. Some audio output is there. Some Ethernet is there. That means whatever may be the interfaces available for the Raspberry Pi, all interfaces available for this one PC Duino. And then the specification, PC Duino specification. Here what are the specification? Here compared to the Raspberry Pi. Here CPU 1 GB, 1 GB ARM Cortex A8. But Raspberry Pi 500 MB. That means M hedges, 500 MB hedges RAM, and then ARM processor, and then GPU. Here, what is the GPU? Graphical processing unit. Here, what is the GPU in this case? OpenGL. That means the processor here. The RAM size. What is the RAM size? It is a 1 GB. Here, compared to the Raspberry Pi, olden days 500 MB RAM size is there. Now it's upgraded to 1 GB, but here PC Duino also upgraded. And then onboard storage for this one. What is an onboard storage? 2 GB flash memory. It is having the onboard storage 2 GB flash memory. That means SD cards also available here. SD cards are, what is the necessity of SD card here in order to storing the operating system. Here, that means in order to storing the operating system files. Here you will use a SD card slot. Here the SD card slot up to 32 GB. Here just like a Raspberry Pi having the video output, just like it's also video output is a HDMI. Here what is an operating system here? Linux plus Arduino, Android. Linux plus Android is an operating system. And then external interfaces are there. Some of the external interfaces. And then some of the network interfaces available here. RJ45 and US. These are something. Some of the specification compared to that. If we compare the Raspberry Pi, here memory is a 500 like that. Compared to the Raspberry Pi, the PC Duino having the this specification. That means it's a the PC Duino is a compared to the Raspberry Pi more expensive and then more power capabilities are there. And then coming to the BeagleBone block, here this one also similar to Raspberry Pi, but it's more powerful. Compared to the Raspberry Pi, it's a more powerful. It is a more powerful means it is a more expensive. Here based on TI Sitara AM335X, an application processor is containing ARM Cortex A8 core that's having the more pin to control. That means compared to the Raspberry Pi, it's having the more number of pins. Here recently one 2013 top embedded in innovator award. That means this kind of BeagleBone having the some award here. That means it's having the compared to the Raspberry Pi, it is a more powerful capabilities. That means it's also a mini computer. That means this is a structure of Raspberry Pi, just like not a BeagleBone. Here just like a Raspberry Pi structure. Here there is a 5 volt is there, HDMI is there, and then USB cable is there, USB connector is there, processor existed, and then the audio jack is there available. Like that, all component, all interfaces just like a Raspberry Pi, but here more powerful. Here if you come to the specification, CPU, here 1 GHz ARM Cortex A8, and then GPU, graphical processing unit, here is a PowerVR SGX530. Here comes to the memory here. Here, what is the memory here? That means the previous PC Duino have the 1 GB. Here compared to the Raspberry Pi and PC Duino having the more powerful capability. And then 512 MB DDR3. And then pin structure having the 46 pins, 2x46 pins headers. And then USB 2.0. USB 2.0 type host port. That means dedicated a single mini USB 2.0 client port here. And then just like a Raspberry Pi HDMI, but here in the Raspberry Pi having the HDMI, but in this BeagleBone having the micro HDMI. Here audio output consists of the Raspberry Pi consists of 3.3 jack is there, but here same HDMI you are using, micro HDMI for both video output and audio output. And then onboard storage information. What is the onboard storage information in this case? 2 GB 8-bit embedded MNC onboard flash version micro SD card 3.3 volt supported. Here operating system, which type of operating supported by the BeagleBone? Here what are the operating systems supported by the BeagleBone? Linux, Android, Cloud 9 IDE, and node.js. And then these are all some of the operating systems supported by the BeagleBone block. Here this is a one type of board. Here coming to the last and QB board. Last board here, that means QB board is a single board computer made in China. It can run Android 4 ICS Ubuntu operating system, and then 12.04 desktop, Fedora 19 ARM Remix desktop. And then this is a some special case you are using the this QB board. The structure of a QB board like this. Here compared to the Raspberry Pi, the structure also same. It's having the all HDMI. That means audio output is there, video output is there. Some processors are there, GPU are there. Like that, all information existed. And then CPU. Here 1 GHz CPU. And then GPU, Mali 400 MP. And then video acceleration. Here it's having the video output. And then there is a extra information, that is a display controller supports a HDMI 1080p. And then coming to the 512 MB beta or 1 GB final DDR3. And then 4 GB NAND, flash built-in, and 1x micro SD slot, and then 1x SATA port available, and then 10/100 Ethernet converter also available, and then it's having the 2x2 USB host and 1 USB OTG, and then 1 CIR, and then 96 extend pin included. This I2C, SPI and LVDS. Here these are all very complicated things about the different Raspberry Pi information. In this session, you are going to know about the programming Raspberry Pi with Python. Here, how can you programming the Raspberry Pi with Python? Here, Raspberry Pi in the sense, PI in the sense, that indicates the Python. That means you are writing the programs to implement the Raspberry Pi by using Python programming, and then Linux operating system. Here you are going to write some Linux commands to implement the Raspberry Pi. That is a simple representation, and then you have a different Linux on Raspberry Pi. Here these are Raspbian. Is a one type of Linux. Raspbian Linux is a, that is a one type of Linux here. That means you are using that kind of Linux. You are not only those that Linux here. You have a other type of information available here. Arch, Fedora, and then these are all different Linux on Raspberry Pi. Here, how can you installing the Raspberry Pi here? Here, what is the installation process for the Raspberry Pi? If you want to install the Raspberry Pi, the first step here, why? Because you are going to executing the Linux commands as well as the Python programming. You are going to executing the Linux programming, Python programming. That's why you need to download the Raspberry Pi software. That means you have to download the required software here, the software and files here. The software, that means go to there is a site is there, raspberrypi.organization. Here under this site you have a download section is there. Click on download section. Here raspberrypi.org. Go to raspberrypi.org. There available the operating systems. Here click on raspberrypi.org. Here under this you have a, that means now available the Raspberry Pi 4 version. Here hardware version. Here, if you identify this one, you will know. That means Raspberry Pi 2, Raspberry Pi 3. That means now available the Raspberry Pi 4. Here, go to downloads. Here, click on downloads. Here, under download, we have a, there is a options are there. Here, what are the option? Raspberry Pi OS, previously called it as a Raspbian, is our official operating system for all nodes. All models of the Raspberry Pi. Use Raspberry Pi Imager for an easy way to install the Raspberry Pi OS. And then other operating system to SD card ready to use. That means you are having the different operating systems are there. Click on this operating system, whatever may be the operating system you are using. And then one is a Raspberryan, and then Noobs. This comes under the Noob. Click on Noobs. Here it is a one type of Raspberryan. Click on Noobs. Here, this Noobs, there is a two operating systems available here. Noobs Lite and then Noobs. Here, click on download the this one, Noobs. that means it takes so much of time to download. Why? Because the size of this file is a 23. Yesterday I tried so many times, but not get it. Okay, I am going to downloading this file in, for example, desktop. Okay, I am downloading that one. Here, that takes so much of time. 2.3 GB. Here, okay, it's downloaded. After downloading this one, what is the next step here? I'm going to. Okay, you download that one. That means you will get the zip file. Yeah, you will get the after downloading this one, you will get the zip file. Extract first. Extract the zip file. Here, extract the zip file. Store in a certain folder. First, extract the zip file. That means if you extracting the zip file, you are having the so many different files, executable, some of the executable files, some of the library files. Here, copy all library files, copy all library files, and get the SD card. Here, get the SD card and a card reader. That means you have to paste in a SD card. Get the SD card and check the drive in which the SD card is mounted, and then format the SD card. Write OS on SD card. Very important step here. Write operating system files. That means already extracted different files available. Here you have to copy the all files from the some Raspberry Pi, and then that means paste into the SD card. That means SD card is ready, and then eject the SD card and place the SD card. There is a slot available on a Raspberry Pi. Under the Raspberry Pi, below the Raspberry Pi, you have a slot for the SD card. Here, better to purchase the SD card size 8 GB or more than 8 GB. Why? Because the size of the operating system 2 GB zip file. If you extract that file, that size may be 4 GB, more than 4 GB. The more than 4 GB, in the sense, you require some of the files for accessing. That's why you better to take the more than 8 GB SD card. Better to take the more than 8 GB SD card. That is a simple information. After extracting that file, the next step in this case here is eject the SD card. Place the SD card. There is a separate under the Raspberry Pi, there is a separate slot for that one. Here, place the SD card under the Raspberry Pi, and then power on the Raspberry Pi. Power on the Raspberry Pi in the sense, you have to attach the Raspberry Pi to any monitor, and then monitor or a computer, you may attach to the computer. After that, you will identify that these steps here. Here, the installation process started. Here, automatically that will ask the installation process. Click on the install. There is a slot available here. Click on install. Then setup file available in this case. Click on setup file. Then it will start the installation. Raspberry and Linux on the desktop on Raspberry Pi. Here, that is a process indeed. That means presently I am not available Raspberry Pi. That's why I am not showing the installation process. If it is available, I can show you later. Okay, this is the installation process for the Raspberry Pi. Olden days it's called it as a Raspberry and Linux. Here that is the installation process. Click on install. After that, file explorer. That means nowadays, so what are the files available? That shows the file available. Then click on next, and then here there is a consoler, the console on the Raspberry Pi. What is the necessity of console on the Raspberry Pi? In the console, you are going to executing the some of the Linux commands. Here the very important question, very important one. Here, what are the Linux commands which are executed on a Raspberry Pi? What are the Linux commands? We have all Linux commands are executed on this Raspberry Pi. Some of the commands will execute. You are going to executing. here, and then browser on the Raspberry Pi. Then next you will identify the browser on the Raspberry Pi. Here, what is the necessity of browser here? By using browser, if you, that means there is a Raspberry Pi is there. The particular Raspberry Pi connect to the TV or more simple monitor. The monitor not having any hardware information, the computer hardware information. Here simply monitor. Here that opens the computer. That means a browser. The, in that browser, you will perform. You will browse the internet. Here you will browse the internet. You may connect the different modem. That is a Raspberry Pi. For providing the internet, there is a Ethernet slot is there. From the Ethernet slot, you are providing the internet. That is a information about the browser on Raspberry Pi, and then Raspberry Pi configuration tool. That means click on this one, then it will install. Here install this one. After installing Raspberry Pi, you have a you are going to executing. You will open the this one console on the Raspberry Pi. Here open the console. The console like this. Here there is a PI, the Pi. There is a slot. For example, if you go to the Linux images, dollar symbol slash symbol is there. Here there is a PI, Pi in the Pi at the rate. You will have the folder. That means it shows the folder option. That means open the console. On the console, you will execute the different Linux commands are there. Here not all Linux commands are executed in the Raspberry Pi, but here some of the Linux command will execute the execute here. Here what are the Linux commands here? You are having the ls command. What is the necessity of ls command here? The ls command here lists the content of the current directory. Here it displays the content here. For example, we have a xyz folder. In the xyz folder, it will display the what are the directories in xyz, and then what are the files in xyz. That means list the all files and directory. Here if you need long list, here -l. Here if you need some other information, -l flag to display the additional information. Long list information, what is an additional information in this case? For example, ls -l. If you type like this, if for example I am typing like this, for example here I am going to typing like this, ls -l. That means here you are going to executing the long list of command. The long list consists of permissions, your owner, group, size, date, and then timestamp of the last edit. Like that you will have the different options here. That is the ls command here. In the Raspberry Pi, some of the very important one, describe the Raspberry Pi, that are Linux commands on Raspberry Pi. Describe the Linux commands on Raspberry Pi. The first one here is a ls command, and then coming to the cd command. Here what is the cd command? Change the directory. For example, you presently you are in c drive. C, for example, I am writing like this, cd home. You are giving the path here, cd some x y. That means x is one directory, y is another directory. Changing to x to y. Cd, that means cd command here changes the current directory to the one specified. That means you can use relative or absolute path here. There is a relative path. Directly you are giving the c drive. Absolute path in the sense slash home slash pi slash directory c. That's called here absolute path. There is a differences are there. That means you are in current directory to current folder. That means you may not having the absolute path. Sometimes there is a requirement of one directory to another directory. You have to change the one directory to another directory folder. Then required the absolute path here. Change cd for the change directory. Here PWD. Here what is a PWD? Present working directory. The present working directory here. PWD command displays the present working directory commands. Here the present working directory. For example, home PI. Which directory presently you are in? That means you are in console. Here a command prompt. In the from the command prompt here you are going to execute in the from the console present working. What is the present working directory? That shows present working directory. And then mkdir. If you want to create the new directory, here use mkdir to create the new directory. For example, mk. For example, Uma. For example, I am writing like this. For example, mkdir space Uma. That means it's going to create in the new directory. Name here is a Uma. Mkdir. That's a example. Mk new directory. It creates a directory new dir in a present working directory. That means if you want to create any folder from the present working directory, from the current folder, then you will use a small mkdir. The next one here is a rmdir. Here, what is the necessity of rmdir? I want to remove the Uma folder. How can you remove the Uma folder? Rmdir Uma. Then it will remove the rmdir. That is a rmdir to remove the empty directory. Empty directory use rmdir. So for example, mkdir old directory will remove the directory old directory only if that directory is empty. That is a important condition. Rmdir. Next one here is a rm command. Here rm command also works in a Raspberry Pi. Here in the console, why? Because it is a Linux plus Python. That means the programming here is a Python, and then operating system is a Linux on a Raspberry Pi. Rm command remove the specified file. It will remove the specified file. Here recursively from the directory when you use minus r. Recursively, if you want to remove the recursively, there is a path. Then you will use minus r. Be careful when this command. The file deleted in this way are mostly gone for the good. Here that is a rm command. That means very very important command here also. Cp command copy the copy file. That means copy of file and place in a specified location. Cp. For example, I want to write like this. Cp. Some file name. Cp. Some x y z. That means you have to specify the location here. Here slash home slash something. That means you have to specify the location. In the which location you are going to copy. Copy file and places it in a specified location. This is similar to the copying and paste. Copying and paste command. Here that is called here cp command. Here mv. Just like a move. Copy command in the sense the previous data existed, but here move in the sense previous data not existed. Move command moves a file and places it in a specified location. So where cp performs a copy paste and move performs a cut and paste. Is it clear or not? Here the copy and paste cp command. Here whereas move command cut and paste command. That means you cannot identify the specified file, the old file not exist in a previous location. That is a move command. Is it clear? Is there any doubt? I think everyone know about the Linux command. In the second year already you have idea about the Linux command. That's why I am explaining directly, not showing any representation. Here cat command. Here what is the cat command? You can use the cat command list the content of the file. Here for example list the, that means the cat command used for the different purposes. The play, for example, displaying the file. Cat file will display the content of this file. Is it clear or not? For example, cat xyz. display the content of the file. Here that can be used to list the content of multiple files also. Here cat stack that will list the content of all txt files in a current directory. That is a cat command. I think everyone know about the cat command. Display the content or the multiple files. Here df command, disk space. Here df command used to display the disk space available and used on a mounted file list. Here disk space, for example, what is the free space and then user space. What is it? That means df minus h indicates, what is the df minus h indicates, the see the output in a human readable format using m for the mb rather than the showing the number of bytes. Here is it clear or not? I think disk space available space, it shows the available space. For that purpose you are using the disk. And then another important one, tar command. Tar command used to store or extract the file from the tape archive file. That means it can reduce the space required by the compressing file similar to the gif file. That is a tar. That means extract the file from the tape archive. That is a tr command. Not only that command, grep command here. That what is the necessity of grep command here? Printing the line matching pattern. For example, if you have in the one paragraph, in that paragraph I want to identify the CSC. For example, Rama is a good boy, Rama studying fourth year, and then Rama having some information here, he is a student, CSC student, and then like that you have some paragraph is there. In that paragraph I want to identify the matching CSC. For example, CSC in which line the CSC is having. That means it's a print the line matching pattern. The particular line, use grep command to search inside files for certain search pattern here. That's for example grep search in txt. The txt file, if you have any search keyword, then identify the such kind of file. That means for searching purpose, you will use a grep command. And then if configure, display the network configuration details here. For displaying the network configuration details, you are using the if configure command in a Raspberry Pi. Very important one here. And then reboot, this is for the rebooting purposes, storing the rebooting, and then shutdown. If you want to shut down the device, in the console you will write a shutdown command. Locate, here search for the file. If you want to search for the particular file, you will use a locate command. And then ls usb, list the usb devices. Next one, net start, print the network connections, routing table, interface statistics. For printing the all information, you are using the this net start command. These are all different command available in a this section. We are going to know about the Python programming on Raspberry Pi. Here Python is a powerful programming language, and then Python is a general purpose high level programming language suitable for providing a foundation to readers. And that means you have some characteristics are there for the Python. It supports more than one programming paradigm. And then interpreted language, the Python is a interpreted language, and then Python is a interpreted language and does not require explicit something. And then interactive language, this one here. What are the benefits of the Python here? What are the some of the benefits regarding the Python here? Here is a easy to learn. You can learn easily. That means, you know, by using C programming, not having any complication, it is having the only easy to learn and read and maintain. And then object procedure language, this one. And then extensible and scalable and portable programming language. And then it's having the broad library support is there. That's why this programming language is very simple and easy understandable programming language, not like a C programming language. Here you have a setup for the Python. How can you execute the setup information in a Python programming? Here the setup for the new Raspberry Pi. Take the setup for the new Raspberry Pi. Already previously I explained about the installation process for the Raspberry Pi. Here you have to do as usual, and then after that you have a some editor is there. Open the Python editor. In this case you have a Python editor. If you see here you have a Python editor is there. Open this Python editor. From the Python editor, if you open this Python editor, the editor appears like this. Here from the editor, here you will execute your Python programming. That is a Python programming. I think you have some idea about the commands. Okay, and then this is a setup here. Run Python and Raspberry Pi using MU editor or as over the SSH. Read input from the physical sensor connected to the Raspberry Pi. Here send output to the external component using Python. This is a some information regarding the Python script. Here in this case, create a unique project with Python and Raspberry Pi. Here if you want to execute this information, you require the knowledge of the data types. Here these are all data type. What is exactly data type? Here the data type in this case, it is a container. For example, the container, the variable is a the data types and variables. Here variable is a container for storing the values. Here unlike other programming languages, Python has no command for declaring the variable. That means you can easily declare the Python variables. Here for example, how can you declare the Python variables? Here see here, open the Python editor. I'm going to open the Python editor. Here this is a Python editor. The Python editor appears like this. For example, a equal to, for example, I have a some salary is there. In the salary I want to store some for expenditure, different purposes I am storing. Let us assume A is a container. A stores 10. I want to print this one. Print A. Here it stores a value. And then for example, B is a string data type. How can you represent a string data type here? The string is represented as a, for example, Rama. Rama is a string. Here the stores the B having a Rama value, which stores the Rama information. That is a B value. For example, I want to print this information. Print B. If you print this one, you will execute the Rama. And then not only that information, here you will having the Python programming, you have a different information names. That means you will declare the variables. For example, if you have the true information, for example, true equal to some 10. It's not a, for example, print true. Let us assume print true, that indicates the value true. Here whatever may be the information, that is a variable. And then coming to the next important one here is a Python numbers. Here in the Python programming, you will execute the different numbers. Here for example, 4 into 5, it's a one type of number, it's a value you say. And then 4 plus 5, that's an value 9. And then that means in the Python programming, you will write a your own numbers as usual. And then coming to the 6 minus 2, it gives a value, here is a 2. That is a some information about the Python setup and the Python number. Here the Python number indicates the numbers are integer, float pointing numbers, complex numbers. Some of the under information we will follow the some numbers here. Here, for example, the Python will take the complex numbers also. For example, you are representing the complex number 1 plus ij. Here, for example, a equal to 1 plus 2j. How can you represent that value here? For example, I want to print that value. Print a. Print a indicates that 1 plus 3j. That means in Python programming, you are having the complex numbers, all different categories of number. Come to the next important thing in this case here is a list. Here, what is the list? Here, how can you represent the list value? For example, variable store, what is the difference here? Variable and list. Variable stores the a simple, for example, if you go to the supermarket, in the supermarket you will have the different items. For example, you purchase the item one equal to onion. For example, item two equal to bread. For example, item three equal to potato. Item two equal to, let us assume any information. For example, item two, what is item two? That means if you want to write this information, you required more number of variables here. That means you required this more number of variables. Instead of avoiding that one, you have a list concept existed in a Python programming. Here, what is the list concept here? List is a order sequence of items. It is a one of the most used data type in a Python. And that means this list is a order data type. That means you will store the information in a particular order. List consists of order sequence. That means all the items in a list do not need to be of the same type. That means declaring a list pretty is straightforward here. For example, a equal to 1, 2, 3, b equal to 3, 4, 5. For example, I'm going to writing the list like this. How can you write the list like this? Instead of writing all this information, for example, u is a one type of. Instead of writing this all information, you will having the list. For example, all information simply represented as a list. There is a bracket, square bracket. In the square bracket, you will having the onion, comma, bread, comma. For example, another important one, u, and then this is a list information. If you print this one, item. If you print the information, here is a item. That means it displays the item. Instead of avoiding the n number of variable, in a simple representation, I am using only one list representation. In the list representation, I can store all these values. That is a list. I think everyone know about this one list. Here, for example, you are writing the list in a string type of list also. Here, for example, I'm going to writing the list like this. For example, list two, let us assume. Here, the for example, 10, comma 20, comma 30, comma 40, comma 50, and so on. This is a simple list representation. In particular list here, how can you store this values list? Print of list of two. List of two. Here it will print the numerical value. Here in a similar way, that means I want to point in the first list. For example, list two. That means I want to represent in the square bracket zero. Square bracket zero indicates that the first element in the list, and then square bracket list square bracket one indicates that second element in the list. You are not a one. List two. List two of square bracket two indicates that the third element in a particular list. Here, in this way, you will find in the list. For example, I want to point in the last element in a list. How can you point the last element in a list? Minus one. The minus one indicates that the particular last element. I don't know about the length of the string. I don't know about the length of the string. For this purpose, I'm going to point in the a particular element in a particular list. For this purpose, I'm using a list concept. That is a some information regarding the list. You have a some differences are there. String as well as the list. That means string as well as the list. And then another important one here is a tuple. Here, what is a tuple here? That tuple is a Python. The tuple is an ordered sequence of item, same as the list. But what is the difference between the tuple and this one? Tuple is immutable. That means a tuple consists of different elements. The tuple you cannot when you are creating the tuple. You cannot modify the tuple. The tuples are used to write a product data and are usually faster than the list. And then it defined within a parenthesis. Here always tuple defined within a particular parenthesis. Brackets. The parenthesis you are using for the defining the tuple. Here I'm going to define the tuple like this. For example, T1 is a tuple. T1 equal to within a parenthesis, for example, 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40. That means print T1. Then it will print the tuple value. What is the main difference here? You can modify the list. For example, already I wrote the list here. You can modify the list, but here tuple cannot modify the values in a tuple. That is a simple information. Here, the more information about the tuple is there. Go to internet and then verify the tuple related information. And then next important concept here is a string. Here, what is a string here? String is a sequence of Unicode characters. You can use single quotation or double quotation to represent a string. Here, you may use the single quotation. You may use the double quotation. For representing the string, you will use this type of quotation. For example, I'm going to take a simple string like this. Here, what is a simple string? For example, I'm representing a simple string. For example, print s. The print s indicates the string value. This is one of the data structure here. Here, if you write like this, multi-line. If you want to write a multi-line string, you will use this type of structure. This is the structure. For example, if you want to multi-line string, this type of structure used for the declaring the multi-line string and then close brackets end here. This is a simple information regarding the string structure. सपरेट क्रिएट चेसिस्तानु कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर्स वीडियोस इस्तानु वेरीफाई चेसुकोंडी यू नीड आई कैन प्लेस डिफरेंट वीडियोस दैट मींस विद इन वन क्लास एक्सप्लेनिंग द ऑल थिंग्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट डिफिकल्ट टास्क दैट्स व्हाई आई कैन टेक द सपरेट वन हियर द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग हियर इज ए कंट्रोल स्ट्रक्चर्स Here, what are the different control structures are there in a Python? If else structure, here. If you want to write this control structure, you required 1 minute. If you go to the Python programming, you will have the different information, if else statement information. Yes, how can you execute this if else statement information? If you want to execute this if else statement information, you require some file. From the file, you will save the file and then execute that one. Here, go to new file. I'm going to execute an if else statement in the same. These are all connected to the control structures. For example, this is a particular program, A equal to 32, B equal to 1. If A is greater than B, then print the value. Save it. Okay, save it. If you want to execute these files, you require a new file. From here, new file, you save it, this file. Here, save this file anyway. Okay, I'm going to saving this file in a my desktop. And then after that, the save file, for example, U1 is a file name that say indicates the Python files. Here, when you are running this program, that means it is a inline editor, a single line, that means A equal to 20. If you want to write a more than one line of code, then you will have a separate file that is called here. That means in this way, you will execute the then statement. If A equal to 33, B equal to some, B is greater than 3. That is a one type of file representation. For example, other one here is a else if. In the Python programming, you have a else if statement is there. Here, for example, I'm going to write a simple program. Here, for example, write this simple program. Simple, write a simple program, and then if you run this program, save this program, and then there is a output like this. A is a, that means what is this program? Here, that means A equal to 33, B equal to 33. If A is greater than A, B is greater than A, then print is a greater than value. Else, if A equal to A and B are the equal. Here, in this case, you will get the output A and B are the equal values. Here, that is a simple representation for the if else statement, and then. Some cases you may write the while state loop statements also in Python. How can you write the loop statements? For executing this program, you will have the loop statement. For example, I equal to 1, while I is greater less than 6 and then print I, that means I'm going to increment in the I value. Here, how can you represent that value here? Here, go to editor. I want to execute this one. For example, loop is a one of the control structure. I equal to 1. While I is less than 6, then you will write a value and then say print I value. Up to how many numbers it will print? It will print the up to less than 6 numbers. Save it and then run it. Run this one. If you run this value here, it will print the values up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the execution for the while statement. Sometimes you may use a break statement. Some other cases, you use a continue statement. You will use a else statement in a while loop also. Here, coming to the for statement. How can you execute the for loop here? A for loop is used to iterating over the sequence. Here, that is either a list or tuple or directory and then sets or string. Here, it's going to iterating the this value. For example, I'm going to take the a particular string as a, I'm taking the particular string here. Here, I'm taking the file. In that file, for example, I'm taking the fruits value. For example, f equal to fruits. And then in this case, how can you represent the f value here? F equal to apple, banana, cherry is there. I want to print all these values. Here, for printing all these values, you will use a for loop. For x in f colon, print x. X in f colon, print x. That is indicates that looping structures in a for loop. If you execute this one, first you have to save this one. After that, run this program. Here, it will print the all information regarding the apple, banana, cherry. This is a way you are representing the all types of loop condition. Here, you may use the for loop for the different purposes here. Looping by using string also. And then in a particular for loop, you will use a break statement. In particular, that is a simple representation for the for loop. We are coming to the very important task in this case. Okay, very important one. Now, like that means control structures over. Before the control structure, you are having the functions. Before the module, you are having the functions. Here, how can you represent a function value? What are the way for representing these functions? Here, we are coming to the function is a block of statement. Here, the function is a block of statement, which only runs when it is called. You can pass the data. You know, for example, you will write your own functions. Python function is defined using def keyword. Here, you will use a def keyword for defining the Python programming. Here, for example, I'm going to defining own function like this. For example, a simple Python program. I'm going to write in the simple Python program. Here, how can you represent that value? Open that one. Here, a simple Python program. For example, defining the my function. Otherwise, you may take the name control. You may take the value in different way. For example, not a MyPython. For example, I am changing the name. For example, any name you may consider. Rama is a one name. Save this one. And then run this one. Not showing anything. Here, it's not showing anything, even though you may call the Python. First, you have to create the Python. After that, you will call the particular Python. How can you call the Python value here? With the name, you will call the Python. Here, go to Python editor. Here, how can I call the Python here? For example, by using drama bracket and with semicolon. That means hello from the function. Here, if you see here, def is a keyboard. Def drama print hello from the Python function. Hello from a function. Here you will have the Python information. You will that means there is a two possibilities for the Python here. One is defining the Python function and then calling the Python function. Here you have arguments are there. What is an argument here? How can you pass the argument? For example, if we have the washing machine. In the washing machine, what is the function of washing machine? Cleaning the clothes. That is a function of washing machine. That means you are defining the function like a cleaning. Let us assume. Here, what are the parameter? The parameter in the sense input values. The input values here cloth. That means parameter you are passing as a cloth for the washing machine, and then it produces a result as a cleaned cloth. Is it clear or not? That is a functions. That means, for example, I'm going to passing the function like this. In a Rama, I'm going to passing the value. For example, take this one. Yeah. For example, I'm going to passing the in Rama. I'm going to passing a value, some x, y, z, or something else. F. For example, I'm passing the value as an f. I'm going to printing that value here plus f. Here, when I'm going to calling this value, Rama. For example, I'm calling this value like this. First, execute this one. Yeah. Save and execute. After that, I'm going to call in the Rama. For example, Rama is a function name. Rama of. You may write a, for example, email. You may write the email here. Rama email. That is the function. The whatever may the information here. For example, if you require break, the hello from a function email. That means you are adding the value here. Will you identify the difference here? The calling the function, ordinary function value. In this way, you will pass the n number of parameter. Not only one parameters here. You may pass the two parameters, three parameters also. Here, I'm going to taking the two parameters here. For example, f is one parameter. Another parameter here is f. G is another parameter. And then I'm going to printing these two values here. How can I print these two values here? One is a f. Let us assume one is a f value. I'm printing the f value. After that, plus there is a space. After that, plus g value. And then if you execute this one, print f and g. Here I'm calling the f and g value. For example, I'm calling the f and Rama space. For example, f value Uma, and then comma, g value Krishna. Rama and Krishna. If you execute this one, it's having some error. You are not having, okay, braces. I need to give some braces for this one. Okay. What is the wrong this one? Okay. When it comes to the program, F, G. And then here I need to give a space. F, G. f comma g value plus. Okay, better to take a single line. Okay, no problem. Okay, in this way you will execute the all different function. Coming to the next important one here, in this case modules. Okay, I can complete here. Tomorrow I can explain about the module as well as the packages. Okay, thank you. Anyone respond, please.